Hello everyone, today I will be sharing with you life cycle of umbrella. First of all, the umbrella is a household item that we have all used. So do you know the types of umbrellas? According to the folding situation, umbrellas will be divided into folding and straight umbrellas. Umbrellas will be divided into rain umbrellas, sun umbrellas, and tent umbrellas according to their use. Umbrellas are daily necessities, but few people know their history. In many countries, especially in ancient China, the umbrella was a symbol of the power of the emperor, the king, and the dignitaries. And was used to cover the sedan chairs or cars in which the emperor or high officials went on their tours. The umbrellas were used to distinguish the status of the people who used them, and the material, color, and size of the umbrellas were also a sign of the size and status of the official. During the Tang Dynasty, the paper industry was well developed and paper was widely used in society. Some craftsmen applied tung oil to the paper to make boiled paper umbrellas that could protect against the rain, and for a while, everyone was holding up paper umbrellas in the rain. Umbrellas were no longer reserved for the aristocracy. In the 12th century that the word umbrella appeared in English. Umbrella comes from the Latin umbra, which means shade, a place of shade. Here is an introduction to the life cycle of umbrella. The life cycle of umbrellas is divided into 6 stages: raw materials, manufacturing, packaging, transport, use of life, end of life, and I would like to introduce each of these stages. For raw materials, umbrellas are usually made from stretchable fabrics and other materials that can be used for the skeleton and the winding thread. The raw materials for polyester are polyethylene terephthalate, dimethyl terephthalate, and ethylene glycol. The skeleton is made from plastic, aluminium, and stainless steel. For manufacturing, first choose a suitable polyester fabric, then cut the umbrella fabric, sew the cut and reduced fabric together. Sew the backbone and fabric together and finally iron the fabric flat. Packaging, most of the market is packed in plastic and a few in boxes made of paper. For transport, the umbrellas are delivered to major supermarkets and retailers in large vans. For use of life, the main purpose of an umbrella in everyday life is to protect you from the rain and the sun on sunny days. Life, usually broken umbrellas are disposed of in the trash. In everyday life, umbrellas contain plastic, metal, wood, paper, and other materials, so if you want to recycle them, the time and manpower wasted is greater than the benefits of recycling, so it is not conducive to recycling, and umbrellas are not harmful to the human body. Section as impact of umbrella. The raw materials face air pollution. The production of polyester fabric produces a lot of dust, short fibers, which can enter the human body through the respiratory system and affect health. Sound pollution. When textile machines are working, there is a lot of noise pollution which affects people's living and rest. In the post-treatment of fabrics, mostly related to water. Through chemicals to treat the color of the fabric, impurities, heating the water containing chemicals. Once the raw material acquisition stage is complete, the primary raw material must be transformed into a secondary raw material that can be used to produce umbrellas. Throughout the manufacturing process of the secondary raw materials, significant greenhouse gas emissions are emitted. Of the secondary raw materials used in umbrellas, stainless steel can be considered to be the least wasteful. Stainless steel production is well interwoven with its recycling process. The average recycled stainless steel content of stainless steel products is around 60%, along with other alloy steels and old scrap, however. The remelting process of stainless steel emits 3.81 tons of carbon dioxide per ton of stainless steel produced. For transport, the main impact on the environment during transport is air pollution. At the end of an umbrella's product life, its components can be recycled in a variety of ways rather than immediately discarded. In the case of umbrellas, upcycling of products is far more common than traditional recycling. The nylon fabric in umbrellas is difficult to recycle and its recyclability depends on the form it is in. As umbrellas are made of polyester, when burned, they release carbon dioxide and irritating gases, which can lead to air pollution. Finally, for the conclusion, the life cycle of umbrellas has many negative effects on the environment, such as air pollution. So the change to sustainable option will be to use more environmentally friendly materials for umbrellas, at least in the choice of fabric. That's all for today. Don't forget to click on, comment and share.